Today we're going to look at how to combine multiple files into a single PDF using Adobe Acrobat. We'll also look at ways you can use Acrobat to save time in a print production workflow by updating PDFs for press safely to avoid re-outputting entire documents. So stick around. Tools in Acrobat can be accessed in a variety of different ways. On the Home tab, you can see a subset of the different tools the program comes with. You can combine files from here. You can go to the File menu and from the Create submenu choose Combine Files into a single PDF. Or you can select the Tools tab, and it's the icon right near the top. Also, when the default sidebar is visible, it's available there as well. So anyway, whichever option you choose from the multitudes available will bring you to the Combine Files screen. Apart from the subtle button in the center of the screen, you can also add specific files you want combined using the dropdown at the top, or select whole folders of files or other sources. For now, we're just going to use the basic Add Files button. From here, you can choose multiple files in the same operation, so if you have all the files you need to combine stored in the same location, you can just select them all at once and hit the Add Files button, and you're done. Each file will show up here as a thumbnail. You can tell if an imported document has multiple pages by the type of thumbnail shown. If you have additional files to add, you can do that by just repeating the process. And once you've got everything loaded that you need, you can just drag the thumbnails to reorder the pages in your PDF. When you're done, just hit the Combine button to generate your new PDF file. And that's really just about it. Your separate documents are now combined together into a single file. All you need to do is save it. Simply go to File Save or hit Command or Control S. Give it a name and click on the Save button. And that's the basics of combining multiple files into a single PDF. If you need to add pages to an existing PDF, you could just use the Combine Files function to accomplish that, but there are capabilities built into Acrobat to do this more easily. From the File menu, you can just choose Insert Pages and then choose a source, which works much the same way as Combine Files, only it adds pages to your existing PDF. But this is actually still harder than it needs to be. If you look at the sidebar to the left, you can see that there is a list of page thumbnails down the side for organizing your document. But rather than scrolling up and down a single column list, if you look over to the Tools list, you'll find the Organize Pages function. From here, you can do the same insert action, but with a much easier grid layout. The Organize Pages workspace is actually one of the most useful features in Acrobat. In addition to the nice clear grid which allows you to easily reorder the pages in your file, if you look at the toolbar, you can find the previously mentioned insert function. And again, this works much like the combined function from earlier. You can choose where you want to insert the file, but since you can easily just drag pages wherever you need them, don't worry too much about these settings. Just rearrange the pages as you need to once they're imported. And finally, we're going to quickly look at another variation of these tools, this time just replacing a page in a PDF. So why would you need to do this? Ordinarily, it's best to re-output a PDF from your source files if possible. But sometimes this can't be done. You may not have access to the original files, or you may need to make only a minor correction to a very large file that would require too much time to recheck if the entire file was emitted again. In any case, Acrobat to the rescue again. From the Organize Pages workspace, just select the page or pages that need replacing, and then revisit the toolbar for the Replace button. Again, the same standard file dialog. Grab your replacement page. One thing worth noting is that you don't have to import every page from the incoming file. You can select a specific page if needed. And once you've confirmed your options, Acrobat will switch out the old page with the new one, or ones. It's worth noting that if you insert or replace pages into a PDF that don't match, then this can cause a lot of problems. This is actually one very good but usually overlooked reason for outputting your finished files to a PDF standard, such as PDF X1A or PDF X4. This way, if a need arises to replace pages in a finished file, you can be sure that you can replace them safely without risk of errors. Anyway, those are a few Acrobat file management basics. Hope they're of some help. Thanks for watching.